Damen und Herren, it is William Kyle from Movie Blogs, and Deben, Oliver, Suzanne, and I are ready to talk about Yindrik. The song is I Don't Feel Hate. The question is, will we feel love for this song? Are you guys ready?
Let's do this!
I don't feel hate, I just feel sorry. So you can wiggle at the made of thing that'll never wiggle back to you. Cause I don't feel.
Yes, Ish Lima Dish Honey. Yindrik has a beautiful story. He was uploading stuff on TikTok saying he wanted to have a song at Eurovision. At the time, it looked like it wasn't a possibility, but then a casting agent saw his videos. He sort of went viral. They were like, OMG, you are amazing. Why don't you audition? He sends in a homemade music video with a lot of washing machines made with his friends, stuff purchased on eBay, and he ends up winning it all. This song carries a very positive message about not kind of responding to shade with hate, but responding to shade with pity, because at the end of the day, if these people got a hate on you for their life force, they ain't got much of a life. Oliver, what do you think of the song?
Listen, when I first heard this, musically, it's a lot. Like, where do we even begin musically? I thought this was in the pits with Electro Velvet. That was my first reaction. And I was like, oh God, Yindrik. I had a lot of hope for him, but it grew on me. Honestly, the first time I heard that chorus, I was like, no, not into it. But then I went on my morning jog, and the entire way walking around the Crosby sand dunes, seeing the steel men on the beach, I was thinking to myself, I don't feel hate, just in my head, over and over and over again. That whistle is infectious. I love that the ukulele is in there. There is just a lot, though. It is a little bit of an assault on the senses, and I can totally get that. But you can tell that Yindrik isn't somebody that goes by halves, you know? He is putting his everything into this, and that could work quite well for him, I think. You know, there will be people who look at this and think, oh my God, he's so quirky, I love it. And there will be people who look at this and say, oh my God, it's so quirky, I hate it. You know, it's another one of the Eurovision 2021 divisive entries. I like that. I love it when things are divisive. You know, I think there's a lot of nice elements in there. It's got this playful, old school Disney Jungle Book feel to it. And yeah, I don't hate this. You know, it's Yindrik doesn't feel the hate, but he's not getting any hate from me whatsoever. It's decent for me.
From England, we head to Atlanta, Georgia. Suzanne, what do you think?
I was kind of like, wow, this song is all over the place. I couldn't locate on our website the official Eurovision video.
What?
I saw one that I initially started watching where he was sitting on a park bench and he had like this cute little umbrella. And then I think I found a different one that I actually watched in its entirety. The umbrella, it reappears. There's this ukulele and there's just so much going on. I felt like I was sitting in this kind of New World Breakfast Club scene.
Can I just check one thing? Was he in a laundromat?
Oh, yes, he was in a laundromat in the second video that I watched.
That's the correct video. I'm so glad you figured it out.
Video. I did watch the correct video. So, you know, he's in this laundromat washing his worries away. Out comes this girl who is, like, shooting a bird. Like, her costume is a shooting bird, right? I was like, okay. So this kind of ties back to Blind Channel. It's like a recurring theme. We've got costume of shooting the bird. We've got a song about putting your middle fingers up. And then we've got two songs named Amen this year. So there's, I don't know, a lot of duplicity this year. So anyway, I really felt that the characters were all different and fun. I did feel like I was sitting in this scene from The Breakfast Club with all the misfits, which made it that much more fun. There was a very islandy, yeah, man. get your groove on, mellow feel to this. So I kind of felt like I was going to the beach, and then there were scenes with the swimming pool and everything else. You know, I don't care if you want to bash me. And then it's almost as though everything that makes each of these individuals different, there's this fun spoof around it, like the gum scene where she's putting gum all over his face. I thought it was really cute that they made a movie of this. Do I think this is going to win? Probably not. When it first opened up, I thought, I generally like Germany songs. Am I going to like this year's song as much as I've liked the others? Well, I will likely not like a German song as much as I like Michael Schulte's song, but
you
I
didn't.
Don't.
Did you like Sisters?
I did like Sisters. You knew that I liked Sisters, and I thought the girls were darling. I didn't think it was going to win, but I did like the song. So long story short, Hendrik is adorable. He seems like he would be so much fun to hang out with. I don't think this is going to win, but it does get in your head and you kind of want to bebop to the chorus, the same thing as say Na 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 with Serhat last year. So it's not the winning song, but it's definitely one that you're going to remember.
Do y'all know what I call Suzanne? Sister! 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 In any case, Devin at RemyWeeBlogs.com, what do you think?
See, Germany is really unusual in its patterns of selection. I mean, you get No Angels, one of Germany's biggest exports, fighting for a spot to represent Germany at Eurovision. You have Cascada, which is one of the world's biggest dance acts, who's had Billboard dance hits and UK number ones, literally fight for a spot to represent Germany at Eurovision. And then you have Jendrik, who's like handpicked by the broadcaster to represent Germany at Eurovision. And guess what?
What?
Guess what?
What?
Doesn't even have to fight for a spot to get into the grand
final. I'm sorry, this is actually incorrect. He went through an internal selection. There were many, many songs in that, and he had to win multiple stages.
If it is not transparent, it didn't happen. So, you know, keeping it real.
Can I say something else? When countries handpick a song, there's a lot of behind-the-scenes negotiations with agents, you know, with labels. It's not just, we want you. It's always more complicated. I think we're oversimplifying here.
And sometimes it could just be as simple as, you're doing it next year, as we have seen repeatedly, time and time again in several selections. But anyway, allow me to finish before you decide to shoot me. So, you know, there is a lot here that there's enough material for resentment. But it's interesting when he then comes up with a song like, I don't feel hate. It's almost like he's addressing the obvious. Like, yeah, I get it. There are reasons to hate me, but I feel sorry for you. There's a lot I've said here in the initial first reaction, so I'm not going to repeat it, but I like this. I like the positivity. I think what I like the most is Jendrik's charisma and his unapologetic tone to just be himself and to celebrate and to go, hey, you know, I know that everybody around me doesn't exactly wish me well, but it's cool because it's their problem, not mine. And you know what? A lot of people can relate to that. And a lot of people are on the other side as well. And it's good for them to actually take a moment of introspection to figure out, hey, why hate on somebody? You know, there could be other emotions you could be expressing. There could be more valuable, it could be more touching, it could be more meaningful, it could be more impactful. This is 3 minutes spent well.
No,
in
that's
his own
five
way.
Minute song, y'all. It was 5 minutes long. I was Honey, like, oh, is it going to end?
That's the extended video. The song itself is 3 minutes.
As you know, Suzanne Adams is research driven. I love that about her.
Uh-oh.
No, Suzanne, don't clap back on your own. You've done well. You've gone above and beyond. You know, I like this. I like this. And another thing I like about it is, oh, God, the point has just escaped me. Oh, Jesus, help me, Lord.
Well, I mean, you were born in the Dark Ages, so we understand the memory loss.
What? Okay, listen. Listen, I...
Oh, no, no, no. But this is exactly the point of Yendrick's video. I pay somebody a compliment, and what do I get in return? I get shade. Completely unacceptable. You know what, Suzanne?
Devin just posted on about attending the first year.
Okay, listen. Jesus is taking the wheel, and he's steering this in a new direction. My turn.
You know what?
Silence. Y'all, can we stop? Can we just stop?
No, we're not stopping. Just because everybody on here is an Adams and I'm an Adoraimi does not give you license to insult me. I don't feel hate for you, but I feel sorry that you cannot broaden your family corridor. How can you just think, do you know what, boo? I'm done. Are we going to scores yet? Who's going to talk? Oh, William.
Okay. Hello. Okay, thank you so much. So there's so much about this that I shouldn't like. However, Yendrick is able to bring it all together. This song lives or dies by the charisma of the performer. If this was sung by someone else, you'd be like, what the hell are they doing? Ukuleles? Then that really loud boom of a chorus? I don't know if Suzanne will get this, but doesn't it sound like an after-school special song that bum, 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 bum? It's like something you would have seen after school, like in the 80s or 90s. It's just, it's a very old song.
I'm the old one?
Can we why is everyone taking everything so personally?
Don't take it personally. Don't be offended.
Listen, I'm trying to focus on the song. So it's bringing together many different musical kind of moments. From the ukulele, it's Jason Mraz meets Stefan Robb. Do you know what I'm saying? It's a little yabba 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 dabba doo-da, whatever his song was. With the Jason Mraz ukulele. It's got cabaret moments at the end when he's like, meine Damen und Herren, you know, ich heiße Yendrick and blah, 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 blah. I think this is obviously divisive. It's not going to work for everyone, but I think many people will be like, I'm voting for the crazy, quirky German. And you know what? That's what you need to get points. I think this could come last. It could. However, I don't want it to. I hope it inches, you know, up the table 15, 16, because I think he's just so charismatic. I think he can sing, actually. We saw on the Schlager show in Germany, he's very charismatic. He can dance, he can move, he's good looking. And they're gonna give it wild staging. He's working with the Roop's choreographer, the Roop in Lithuania. And they're, again, very quirky, very out there. And so they're gonna create a routine, a program tailored to his strengths. Now, in that first round, no one suggested this was the winner, but I'm curious how high you think it can climb, Oliver.
It's going to struggle to get out of the bottom five. It really is. And I think some of that comes from the age-old conversation of having the big five in the semis. Because if this has the earworm quality, you know, we've all picked up on it. It's got a catchiness to it. If that had more time to grow, if that had more time to grow on people and get stuck in people's heads, maybe moving from the semifinals, I think it could peak somewhere around the 17th mark. But it's in a strong field. It's not got too much going for it in the way of the criteria that juries look for. I think I'm going to be very specific and say 22nd place for Germany this year. Definitely somewhere in that bottom bracket, unfortunately. I want it to do well. I do. Yendrick deserves it. But you know what? He's not going in it to win. He's going in it to have fun. And I give him props for that.
Lyrical.
How do you know? I mean, he's going in to have fun. I mean, really.
Lyrical interlude, because I don't feel hate, I just feel sorry. You feel so very clever whenever you find another way to wear me down, but I don't feel hate, I just feel sorry. So you can wiggle that middle finger, it'll never wiggle back to you, because I don't feel hate, Suzanne.
I don't see this doing super well, but it is a fun, fun song. To Oliver's point, we are not going to hear it the entire 2 weeks as we are going to hear other songs. I'm going to put it in the bottom 10, although, you know, it could be a grower versus a shower.
What?
And he could surprise us all.
Girl, your knowledge of things is killing me. Damn it, Adoremi.
You know, I feel that, you know, it hasn't got to fight for a spot to get into the grand final. It's there anyway. And, you know, and I think that's what's important here. You know, Jendrik is not, he's got a good voice, but he's not a singer. You know, he hasn't got a singer voice. He's not a belter. He's not a balladeer. He's not, you know, he's just, charisma is his biggest strength. And his, you know, another big strength is a really powerful message. Yes, it comes across as quite gimmicky and kind of playful, but actually, this packs a lot of meaning. You know, those lyrics that you kind of transcribed just now, that's some really serious, heavy stuff. You know, and it's a very light-hearted approach at combating depression and anxiety, and just the inferiority complexes, you know, and I think that, yeah, kudos to him. I'm glad that this is in the show, and I'm glad it's in the grand final. I'm glad that 170 million people plus will get to see and enjoy this, and I think that he's going to build on his recognition, and he'll be a much loved part of the Eurovision fandom. I think that this will go on to be a fan favorite, you know, and I think that this will be a clapback anthem. You know, he's ticked so many boxes. And if you're in the grand final anyway, I mean, half these people just want to qualify. Oh, he's in it. You know, I really don't care where he places. I don't think he'll place particularly high. But even finishing in the lower rankings, it's not a big deal. He gets to share his message and his song and his playful, engaging spirit. And he'll be remembered. This will be remembered.
You know, I was on the phone, or rather on Zoom, with Samantha Tina the other day, and I talked to her about how people in Latvia have said, your video features a same-sex kiss, you know, you need to be banned, that they're launching petitions, and she said, you know, I send them love. I send them love. The best way to respond to hate is to make it a positive. Send them pity. Send them condolences. Send them love. And that's what Jendrik is doing. This is a positive, life-affirming song. It's a good coping mechanism, strategy. It's also relevant beyond shade and haters. If you look at the rise of right-wing populism, you look at hate, you know, that's being spewed all over the place. You look at how social media has become a cesspit of toxicity. You know, look at the former president of the United States and how there was a rise in kind of angry social media discourse. What I'm trying to say is this song taps into a broader zeitgeist that applies and works on many levels. The Germans, they know that. They're a very smart team, and they clearly see this working on many levels. Now, will this translate to votes? I think this is a song many people will like. I think it's a song many people will have positive feelings for and remember, but that doesn't always translate into votes. Because at the end of the day, you vote for your one or two knockouts, right? You're not sitting there, maybe Suzanne Adams is, I'm not sitting there voting for 10 songs. You're voting for one or two that you really, really love and want to get behind. So I think he'll be liked by many, but I don't necessarily see this, you know, reaching the top 50. I think 15 is like the upper ceiling, but I think realistically it's going to be bottom five, because I don't think jurors will be putting this in their top 10. I think a lot of them will enjoy it and love it. But at the end of the day, jurors know that their name is released publicly and attached to a song. And I think if it was anonymous, maybe this could get more love. But I think jurors will be too concerned about their reputation and the shade that might come. But I wish him the best. I think he's lovely. He's very handsome. And the Schlager Show performance, if you haven't seen it, please go find it, because it will light up your life. All right. Let's now go around and give our scores out of 10, along with the justification, starting with Oliver.
It's a 6 from me. There are elements to this that I do really like. Love the inclusion of the ukulele. Love the strange kind of like trumpet with the mew and the whistling. Lots of fun. And most of the points that I gave this, they do come from Jendrik and his charisma. And the meaning that you can extract from this is much deeper than surface level. And if anybody can pull off an act as zany as this, it's absolutely Jendrik. if another performer had given this, if another performer had done this, you know, it would be, it's just not suited to anybody but for him. It's specifically a Jendrik song. And I definitely give him props for sticking to his guns. So just around an average score for me.
Suzanne.
I went with a 5.5. I think that, oh, there was one more moment I really liked, the WTF moment with the larger guy. Like, he and I said it at the same time, and it was really funny. But anyway, I guess you had to be in my living room to understand it. So I went with a 5.5 because it was just so busy. There were moments where I was like, what's going on? What am I doing? I felt like we were just kind of all over the place. Really like Jendrik. Other than that, enjoy the song, enjoy the chorus, but it was super, super busy. And if I'm listening to music, I don't really want to have to think. And I felt as I was watching the video that I had to think about it.
Girls always taking notes during songs. So that might explain why you were thinking. Devin had a RemyWeBlogs.com.
I gave this a 5.5 as well. I like the fact that Jendrik is homegrown. A part of me feels like, you know, he's the star that we kind of just adopted in the Eurovision community, and we've just grown with him from inception, really. Like, you know, he's not coming with slaying goods. And yeah, I mean, that's a point of critique, but that's also a point of, there's something endearing about that. So yeah, I give this a 5.5 because I think that's, it sits comfortably above average, but yeah, but there's still room for progress, you know, for future releases or future appearances even at Eurovision.
This is a song, when I hear it, even if I'm not actively trying to hear it, like it comes on my, you know, it comes on YouTube or something as an auto kind of suggestion, it gets stuck in your ears, an earworm, right? It has that earworm quality. And I think that suggests he's written something quite good, something with merit. I think staging is going to be crucial to this. I hope they recreate the intimacy. I'd love to see the laundromat writ large on the Lithuanian stage, or rather writ large on the Rotterdam stage, forgive me. I think if they carry that over, it'll be fun and quirky and different. Who else is going to have washing machines on the stage? Who else is going to have exploding holly powder? There's so much in this that's memorable and likable. The middle finger.
Sunshine.
Could you say that again, love?
Little Miss Sunshine.
Little Miss Sunshine, bringing those UV rays. Y'all better have your SPF 40. All of this is working in its favor. However, for me as an audio cut, it's not, it doesn't necessarily work. The staging is essential, and that's why I love the music video. And with all of that in mind, my score was a 6. But you know, he's got the charisma, uniqueness, nerve, and talent to deliver something worthy of the main stage. Well, we of course are not the only WeeWee bloggers. There are dozens of us all over the world, from Australia to Italy to the United States, via Kaliningrad and all sorts of other places. And they have also given their scores. And when I take the overall global average, we get 5.14. So very much in line with what all of us said. I think this is a fair score. I don't think it's an insult. I don't think it's hate. I think if that score could speak, it would have a lot of nice things to say, but it's also realistic about what the other competition is bringing this year.
I think that's a fair assessment.
Suzanne?
Absolutely agreed. Oh, sorry.
I just wanted to catch her off guard to see the face. The blank expression. Girl. In any case, that's what we think. What do you think? What is your score for Jendrik's I Don't Feel Hate? Do you think this could win the Eurovision Song Contest 2021? Do you think it's destined for the bottom five? Let us know here on WeeWee Blogs.
Don't forget to like, follow, subscribe on all of our social media platforms. Such as...
What?
Pinterest!
Facebook, Pinterest. Twitter, Spotify, Clubhouse, TikTok.
And stay tuned for more Wee Wee Jory videos. We're going around all of the countries of Eurovision 2021 to give our ratings, reviews, and reactions.
Sister! And we'll see you later. Bye!
Bye!